are you doing? Any glass with a stem will usually work. You can play music on your stemware, I promise. As long as you have a stem on the glass, you can usually make a sound. Your fingers have to be really clean. Get all the oil off your fingers, and you get your fingers wet, and you rub the top of the glass. You're trying to create friction, and you do that by pressing down a little bit. And if you press it down just the right way, you get the glass to vibrate. That's what you're hearing. The glass is shaking. You can see the water moving in that one right there. That's a low frequency. You can actually see the water moving right there as well. So the part above the water line is what's vibrating, giving you that sound. And that's why it's a water-tuned instrument. It depends on how much water you got in the glass to get the note. The bigger the glass is, the lower range of notes. It does not have to be crystal. I promise you, the button in Fort Lauderdale, not known for its fine stemware. It's water-tuned. I can show you. This is my tuner. You can hear this note. You can't come closer. That's a C. You take this tuner right here, and I'm going to take some water out. And let's know what happens to that note. I'm going to take that C and turn it into a C sharp just by taking water out. The less water, the higher the pitch. It's now, you hear the difference there? Way too much time on my hands. So an empty glass, it makes sense, an empty glass is the highest note that the glass can be. Start adding water and you find out what kind of range the glass has. Some glasses have a big range. This one, for instance, has about 2 octaves worth of notes in it. So I use a tuner to help me find the notes. And then after a while, if you play the glasses long enough, you get a nice little mineral deposit around the glass there. So when I get here to set up, I pour the water up to that deposit, then I fine tune it. Takes about 15 minutes to get it going. Thank you for sticking with me there. I'm going to retune my glass now.